Alright guys, that's Chatterbox Reviews, coming at you guys with SEAL Team, Season 1, Episode 2, Review. So, I enjoyed this episode quite a bit, guys, honestly. The thing is, though, I actually thought this episode was better than last week's episode, at least in my opinion, right? I honestly, and it's weird, right, because usually pilots, they're usually, the best product, they put a lot into them, because, sometimes even, that pilot is just, hopefully what's gonna warrant the rest of the season, right, in some situations, and then also, it's to get the viewers on it, and, get them interested in the show, so they keep watching the rest of the season. So, pilots are big, right, and usually the pilots are really well done, one of, the best episodes of the seasons on shows, but, I don't know. Now, I'm not saying I didn't like the pilot, I did, but I thought this one was a little bit better, which is odd, right? Usually it's not, but, I don't know what happened there. I don't know. This one does have negatives as well, right? It's not perfect by any means, but, I did enjoy it a little bit more. So, I just thought I'd mention that. I thought that was kind of, a little bit out of the ordinary, right, for typical TV shows. I'm not sure what happened there. Maybe that's just my opinion, too. Maybe everyone else liked the pilot better. I don't know. But, I really liked this episode. I thought, as long as episode 1, 2, and 3 are, pretty good, I think that this, this show, this and The Brave both, can have a good rest of the season, to be honest. So I don't think they're gonna, fall too much if those first three episodes are good, because typically that's what people, give a chance to, right? The first three usually, or the first two even. And if they like them, okay, then they'll keep watching until, something big happens that turns them off, or something big happens that turns, them on about the show, and then they, they're fans and they wanna, keep watching. So I do apologize for this one being so late. I mean, this aired on Wednesday night, this episode, and I mean, it's here Saturday. So, I really apologize for that. I've been really, really busy lately. But I really want to stay on top of these reviews. I try to get these out the day after the episode airs, and I just haven't been able to do that lately. So, I really apologize for that. I really do feel bad about that. In the future, I'm going to try to do it. I'm definitely going to keep on top of these reviews. Just whether or not they're on the day later, it remains to be seen, I guess. But, So, anyways, getting to it now. SEAL Team Episode 2. Just a quick recap I'm going to go over. And then, of course, my rating, favorite character, my overall thoughts, that typical stuff. Let's get right into it. So, this episode, we start off, we see Jason and his wife talking about, splitting up for a while. She's saying that, it's not a good idea that he's back at the house or whatever, and, because they're still split up, they don't want to give the kids the wrong idea and stuff like that, which, is kind of a little bit of a cliche, right? We've seen that before, but I liked it. I thought it, it felt real. And then we also see a cool little flashback scene there as well with Jason. He kind of sees the party through the window, of when his wife and him split up, or decided to split up for the first time. So that was kind of interesting too. Cool little, at work there with the editing and all that, right? Showing like the scene through the window and him looking at it was pretty cool. And then we also see more of the family life with Ray, right? We see the ultrasound of his wife there. And it shows that the baby is coming soon. A little bit quicker or sooner than I thought that it was going to come. The doctor says he should be back in time for the birth, because he gets called to another mission on his pager, and, then they kind of, figure out that he should be back in time, for the birth of his baby, and it's, obviously a big deal, right, for Ray and his wife for Ray to be there, when the baby is born finally. So that was, another, part of that family life. That and the end were kind of the only ones in this episode. Last episode, they focused a little bit more on it with like the therapist at the beginning as well. So I thought that was a good part there, the good part in the beginning. I do really like the whole family aspect of this show. I really do appreciate that. I think it's, obviously a real problem, in our, society with, these soldiers, you know, PTSD and stuff like that. No, I'm not saying any of this is PTSD related, right? I'm just saying, like, the outside of, you know, serving sort of life there, right? You know, going home to their families and whatever. And we see that again at the end with Jason. So, yeah, I feel like that's a really important part of this show. And I feel like that's kind of what separates it apart from the Brave, Valor, and SWAT that are all coming on this fall season. And they're all going to be, you know, military drama shows. So, yeah, definitely a good thing there for them. And kudos to them for you know, figuring that out and making that a reality with the show. So then we see Clay's training for the Green Team, I guess. So Clay Spencer. And I don't really get this. So I don't know how he went on that mission last week in last week's episode, you know, for the big Abu Samir or whatever. He seemed like a big guy to get. So it was a pretty big mission. And so he went on that. And then all of a sudden now he's kind of like been downgraded like a lot. And now he's like trying to, he's basically training or trying out for this new team. So yeah, doesn't make much sense to me. Like, I don't understand how, you know, he can be, you know, on this mission last week, this really important high stakes mission. And then all of a sudden now he's trying out again. So I don't know. And Jason didn't really, you know, like he covered for him too. So I don't know. But we learned that, you know, we see that he's doing very well against the other guys. And I thought that was a great scene, you know, where he's going through the course. They had some good music in the background as well. I really liked that. That was kind of a cool scene. That was, you know, like kind of what you expect from a military, you know, show or movie, right? You know, that part where, you know, all the men are going through the course and the climbing the ropes and everything. So, yeah, definitely been done before, but I thought it was a good scene for the show, especially, you know, and seeing Clay doing so well, kind of excelling there. And then after they're done for the day, his commander basically, you know, tells the guys about the, you know, top five, bottom five thing. So basically, you know, all the guys vote on the top five and bottom five. And then, you know, the guy at the bottom of the, or the, yeah, the guy at the bottom of the bottom five is then sent home. So, you know, he's, you know, done for good. So obviously Clay, you know, he doesn't want to be that guy. And you know, he's overperforming people, right? You know, he's probably, you know, one of the best there. So, you know, theoretically he should be in the top five, but it's the other guys that are voting as well. So you got to keep that in mind. And he kind of learns a lesson there as well as the episode goes on. So yeah, I like the, parallel storylines in this episode, but I don't know if I was like a really big fan of that whole storyline, you know, in this episode. But anyways, yeah, so that was kind of like Clay's portion of the episode there. So then we, of course, you know, get back to Jason's team. So basically they get assigned this mission to go into Syria and see what is happening with the cattle there. So they, you know, have picture, the satellite pictures of the cattle, and all of a sudden, you know, they're, you know, all these, you know, dead cattle are basically turning up, and, you know, they see these on the satellite pictures. So obviously, you know, something's going on here. So basically they're ordered, you know, to get samples of the substance, that had a supposed leak that they think led to the death of all these cattle. So, and then they also find out that it's the deadliest chemical known to man, they say, VAX or something, or yeah, I think that was it. I think that was the chemical name that they said. And yeah, so, basically the doctor ends up, you know, he has to go with them, and that created a lot of comedy in this episode as well, that I really appreciated. And so yeah, so the doctor has to go with them to get these samples, and they're basically, you know, gonna lock down the hospital there where they suspect that this leak came from, so, you know, they can get this chemical and hopefully just get out, so that the U.S., you know, can have proof that they, you know, had a leak of this substance. So yeah, so an interesting mission, right? A little bit different from last week, of course, you know, with the whole hostage and killing. They're not really going after anyone in particular. You know, they're kind of going after something. So I like this a lot too, right? I like that they're kind of changing up the missions a little bit. So yeah, so really interesting scene here. Kind of really cool that the team has to basically skydive out of the helicopter there to get down into Syria, because they can't, you know, fly over the airspace or whatever like that, you know, really close to the ground, they can't land. So yeah, I thought that was a really cool scene, where they, you know, all skydived, and the doctor has to go off there, so it's kind of funny. But yeah, I thought it was a really cool scene, and oh my god, like, one of the funniest parts of the episode was, the guy, putting this, like, he puts the goggles on this dog, and a gator mask, like a alligator mask on the dog. Like, that was really funny. It's just hilarious, like, that they have to bring this dog with them everywhere, right? So, you know, like, everywhere they go, you know, the dog has to do the same as them to get down. So the dog, you know, goes skydiving with this guy down, like, you know, attached to his waist. So, yeah, that was funny. I didn't really like that, that there. That was funny. But yeah, and then when they dropped down, you know, they're kind of traveling on foot to the hospital here, and they had a quite, you know, substantial amount of distance to cover to the hospital. Very intense scene, right? We saw it kind of in the green, you know, the green lenses, right? Because, you know, the night vision or whatever. And yeah, really intense, right? You know, they're kind of walking there. You don't know what's going to happen. You don't know who's, you know, going to jump out at them. And yeah, so then we see them kind of get finally to the hospital there. They clear the building. They take out, you know, some guards very quickly, by the way. Like, they literally jumped down. They couldn't even fire at once before, you know, they got shot in the head or shot down at least. And yeah, so they clear the building. They take out the guards. And they find the chemical room to where, you know, where the leak, you know, supposedly happened. And the doctor is basically, you know, set there to get some samples of the chemical, right? Because that's sort of the whole mission. So, yeah, I thought that was good. Another thing, right, you know, they seem, you know, last episode and this episode, they seem to get to the place. They're able to clear the building, you know, think that it's kind of safe. And then all of a sudden something happens. So that's happened in both episodes where it kind of seemed too easy. And then, you know, all of a sudden something happens and, you know, they're faced with a challenge or a problem. And yeah, I mean, I like that, but, you know, let's not keep it too repetitive, right? So yeah, but that was a really intense scene, you know, with them getting to the hospital and clearing it with the night vision. I really like the perspective stuff they do in this show as well, right? You know, we kind of see through, you know, Jason's perspective of what he's seeing, you know, when he fires. So that's really well done as well. I like that. It's, you know, I really like that. So then Jason's team goes to the second floor, or I guess, you know, not, yeah, Jason's team, but like without him, go to the second floor. And they basically find all these Syrian people that work at the hospital that are, like, just, you know, like, I know. Like, I say disabled, but I don't, like, you know, that's really the right term. Yeah, I don't know. Like, they're affected by this gas leak, of course, right? So, I don't know about disabled, but, like, you know, they couldn't really walk properly. You know, they can't really function properly because of this, you know, gas getting to them. So anyways, there was 23 of them basically, and they find them on the second floor of this hospital, and, you know, they're shocked because they didn't think anyone would be in there. But, you know, they're the people that worked at the hospital. So basically, you know, we learned the chemicals infected them, and basically they're all slowly dying, really, right? I mean, if they don't get any treatment soon for this chemical, then they will die eventually, and we do see that come true. So, yeah, Jason, you know, at first, of course, you know, the moral thing is, you know, he wants to bring them all back so they can survive, right? You know, he wants to help them out, wants to get them back, get them, you know, some attention. But the commander back on the plane cannot convince the high up guys, the generals, to authorize more vehicles. To come in and ship all these people out, because they only have two vehicles as of now taking them back, so they can never fit all these people onto those two vehicles with them, you know, unless they stay, right? So, so yeah, it's a, you know, tough decision there, and the commander just can't convince them. So yeah, so basically the only decision is to, they have to leave them, right? So the mission stays the same, and the commander says, you know, focus on the samples, and we'll have to, you know, come back for them and leave them there for now. So, obviously then, Jason's faced with this moral decision, right, of leaving them there, and, you know, that's a tough decision for a leader like Jason, and, you know, he's really, you know, shown some great leadership qualities so far, so I really had no doubt in him, with this one, but, yeah, really very, you know, emotional scenes there with Jason holding the young boy who was dying, and, you know, and then we see Jason's son at the end of the episode, and it just becomes, you know, a lot more emotional there, you know, that Jason probably, you know, sees his own son in this little boy. So, yeah, really, really tough scene there, for Jason, of course, and the scene at the very end was very, very sad. So yeah, but yeah, just, you know, emotional scenes there, and he kind of comforts the boy though, which was, you know, nice warm moment there. And then they're kind of, you know, they're getting the substances and they're, you know, almost ready to leave. And then Jason is able to come up with a plan. So him and Ray basically come up with this, and I thought this was the best part of the episode, like this little twist and the way, you know, they're smart enough to think of this. But basically they lied to the commander that the samples that the doctor took are contaminated and that they need to bring the 23 people back as evidence of this chemical leak. Because, you know, right? Because, you know, the samples are contaminated. They can't prove that this chemical was there. But they have these 23 people that can prove it because they, you know, inhaled it and they're dying from this chemical leak. So, you know, really smart, right? Really smart because they need proof, right? And these people are the only proof, so they have to bring them. So, yeah, definitely really smart, you know, plan there by Jason and Ray. Really great, you know, working together as well in this episode and, you know, I think in this whole season too. I really like that dynamic with Ray and Jason. I think they're, you know, really great for each other. And yeah, so basically more vehicles then are sent by the officials and, the plan works in the end. So yeah, that was really great plan. And, they end up basically outsmarting these generals and, ended up bringing all these people back. So yeah, really great, great to see there. And obviously, you know, the right thing to do, right? For Jason's, you know, aspect there, or his point of view. So then the team agrees then to stay a little longer in order to save the workers, because, you know, they have to wait a little bit longer for these vehicles to get there. So yeah, you know, of course the team's gonna volunteer and say that they want to stay a little longer. Of course, this increases the risk though of them, you know, getting caught by, you know, these Syrian soldiers basically that are on their way there, you know, to kind of stop them. So yeah, really, you know, intense scene. This was probably the most, you know, action intense scene of the whole episode. Them getting out in the Humvees, you know, out of the hospital. They just get out in time before there's a big explosion right beside the hospital. That definitely would have wiped, you know, a few of them out. It was a big explosion. So, you know, we see the explosions, the shooting, the high speed that the vehicles are going, you know, everything. So really intense scene. Honestly, I really, really enjoyed this. I was, you know, on the edge of my seat for this scene. I was like, is someone gonna die? Like, this is just, like, this is awesome, right? Adrenaline, you know, pumping. So, yeah, I thought it was a really great scene there, really well done, right? It seemed really realistic, and we saw, again, point of view, right, for perspective, I guess, from Jason in this as well, you know, kind of looking around and seeing what's going on. So that was great as well. And then, you know, the guy on the top in the turret, you know, kind of shooting around at these you know, soldiers. So that was really great. I really like that scene. And then, of course, yeah, you know, the most sad, you know, or the saddest scene of the whole episode here is then, you know, the young boy dying in Jason's arms there in the Humvee. So, yeah, very emotional moment for him, right? I mean, you know, he kind of comforts this kid throughout the whole episode. He even gives him this ring or whatever, you know, give him hope and you know, hopefully that he'll stick this one out until he gets help. And he ends up, he doesn't, so he ends up dying. So, yeah, really emotional moment there, definitely sad. And I mean, we, you know, obviously, it's not like a character death where we love the character and they die, you know, right? It's just not the same, but you still feel sad, of course, right? It's just a sad moment, you know, and it really, you know, invokes, you know, emotion in that scene as well, because it's a young boy. And, you know, he comforted him, right? If it was just a young boy and he had nothing to do with him in the rest of the episode, maybe we even wouldn't have felt that attachment either, right? So, yeah, and basically shows the negative parts of the job, right? That they have to see that, you know, when they go on these missions, they have to, you know, that's part of the job. You know, that's going to happen. People are going to die, you know, in front of them, in their arms. You know, and of course, you know, Nate died at the beginning of last episode, right? In that mission, you know, their own friends are going to die that serve with them. So, yeah, definitely this job is negative. It has a lot of positives, but definitely some negative parts as well. And I really like that they're showing, you know, negative stuff as well, not just, you know, the big action and, you know, they're, you know, big guys, you know, SEAL team, whatever, right? So, for sure. So then we find out Clay is put in the bottom five. So it just kind of shows how cocky he is. right? Because, you know, he goes up and he thinks, you know, he's all high and mighty and he thinks he's going to be in the top five. And he's in the bottom five and he's actually third last. So he doesn't go home, but he's third last. So he's two away. And yeah, basically he's being a dick to the other guys in the tryout. And that's basically why he's in the bottom five, right? Other guys are kind of helping each other out, you know, giving support to people. And he's just kind of the show-off, you know, cocky guy who's doing whatever he wants, you know, without helping other people, without any other sympathy for other people. And I think he deserved bottom five. I think he may even deserve to go home, to be honest, the way he's acting. And, yeah, I don't know. It just shows, you know, his kind of behavior. But with this, I don't know where his storyline is really going at this point. Because, yeah, I mean, he's a cocky guy. So, obviously, you know, he's going to have to change or else he's going to go home. That's just sort of the bottom line here, right? So I'm wondering if maybe they're going to take us through, you know, him changing and then eventually maybe halfway through the season he's going to join the SEAL team again and he's going to go on missions with them. I don't know. I mean, he's already went on a mission with them last episode and I really don't understand that now in context to what's happening with his storyline now. So I don't know. I don't know where his storyline is going. I don't know, you know, where they're going to shape him in to be by the end of the season. I would think, you know, that he maybe is a long Jason and Ray. You know, maybe, I guess. I don't know. But we'll have to see for sure if, you know, where he's going to go and if this tryout ends up being good for him in the long run. So, yeah, I mean, I did like the dynamic there where they kind of had two kind of plots in this episode with the mission and then Clay. But, yeah, I just don't know in the future where that's going to go. So then we see they get back home, and this is kind of the family part again. Ray's wife actually has the baby when he is away, and he goes and sees her at the hospital, of course, right when he gets back. This is just kind of a thing. Like, this is just a CBS drama sort of thing. But so they're at the hospital, and he's, you know, comforting her in the bed. She's holding the baby, and this baby is, like, pale white. So I don't understand. Like, I don't know. I don't know, it is CBS, you know, you kind of get used to these things, and some TV shows do this, right? You know, maybe it is hard to find babies, you know, that are going to act in a freaking TV show that are the exact same, you know, skin color as these actors, but I don't know, I think they could have made it a little bit more realistic. Like, it was really pale white, like, I mean, and Ray and his wife are both, like, neither of them are white, by any means. So, I don't know. It was just a little bit weird, right? And it kind of needs to be brought up. But anyways, yeah, a little weird, but obviously that's not the main point of the scene. And I get that too, right? I'm not focusing on it, but I thought I'd bring it up. So, yeah, really warm scene there for Ray and his wife to kind of, you know, be together with their newborn. And yeah, really great. Another kid to add to that family. So then Jace goes back home to his wife and son. And yeah, this is kind of where you see the sort of PTSD stuff that I was talking about, where he lies about the mission. He says everything went great. So, and obviously everything didn't go great. You know, a young boy died in his arms, you know, 23 people, that he had to save. And also he had to walk over, and over all these dead bodies in the hospital that we saw. And that was just tragic, right? And it was kind of nonchalant, though, at one point, because they're just kind of stepping over them because they have to get past them. So, yeah, really, you know, emotional mission, actually. And he's saying everything went fine. And, you know, the mission went great. And, you know, obviously, maybe that's his coping method. Maybe he can't tell her classified info. I thought of that, actually, afterwards. So, maybe, but I don't think he really has to, you know, lie about it, even if he can't tell her classified info. Okay, well, say it was bad, but, I mean, you don't have to tell her, you know, all the information, but anyways, yeah, so that was just kind of, you know, another sort of scene there that shows us, you know, the life behind the missions. So then, of course, you know, after he talks to his wife, then we see, you know, a great scene there with his son. You know, how the son kind of helps him, tape up a box or whatever, and he kind of, you know, smiles, obviously, you know, he you know, admires his son as well, and then, you know, that's the part I was talking about earlier, right, where he has his own son, and, you know, this little boy, who is probably around the same age, you know, kind of died in his arms there, and, you know, see that, you know, connection there that that he makes, you know, because he has his own son. So yeah, really really great, you know, showing there of sort of the family aspect, you know, what happens beyond these missions, you know, what they can do about it, right? So I think that's going to be like more of the show as well, you know, like what can they do about it. You know, I think that we're going to see more of Jason with his therapist and seeing, you know, what he can accomplish with that. I think that's an important part of the show as well. So yeah, so then basically the episode ends. That is the episode there. So yeah, very condensed, of course. But yeah, so yeah, that is basically the recap of this episode, episode 2 of SEAL Team. So now I'm going to get to my rating and my favorite character for this one. So my rating is a 4.3 out of 5 for this episode. I believe last week I gave it a 4.2 or 4.1. So yeah, I did like this better than the pilot, like I said at the beginning, and yeah, so I just thought it was a little bit better. Obviously not a lot, and there were some things wrong with this one, but all in all, pretty good. So basically, I thought it was some great comedy this episode in, you know, what is a dark show, right? With especially, you know, like the deaths of these people. It was a pretty dark episode, and the comedy that they had was great. You know, with the doctor, that was like a big portion of the comedy. The dog going down with the mask on, that was hilarious. And yeah, so just stuff like that. And the stuff with Clay was really funny too. That scene where he's in the bar trying to pick up the girl. So that was funny as well. And I do like that. I do like a little bit of comedy, right? Because this show is pretty serious. And, you know, a lot of fans, you know, like a lot of TV watchers, they tune in TV shows, you know, to be entertained, have some fun. And, you know, don't get me wrong. I guess some people, obviously, they do tune in for some serious stuff as well, right? There's definitely serious dramas out there that are really popular, where people, you know, die every week. But, you know, a lot of people, you know, also just like that sort of, you know, light and fun stuff as well. So you gotta, you know, do a little bit of both. And I feel like the comedy balance was good. You know, it's not too much, but not too little. I think it's, you know, just perfect for this show so far, at least in this episode and the pilot. The pilot was good with it too. So yeah, I thought it was, you know, still a stereotypical kind of military drama. I don't know. There wasn't like anything special. I did like that this mission was a lot different than last week's mission. You know, I will be comparing these shows, by the way, quite a bit, The Brave and this, so just stick with me for this one. If you don't watch The Brave, I suggest it for sure, definitely, and I do reviews for that as well. But yeah, The Brave, their first two episodes were kind of the same sort of mission, and it kind of is already getting repetitive with just two episodes, so I feel like that was a positive for this one, doing a different mission. Only thing I'd say, though, is, again, like, it's kind of stereotypical, like, oh, you know, Syria's releasing this toxic gas, U.S. needs to have, you know, intel on it or whatever, so we have to go in and get samples. So, I don't know, you know, just some stereotypical stuff, and, you know, them clearing the building again, just like last episode. So, yeah, and of course, you know, that's what you're tuning in for, right? I mean, that's just what the show is. And so, yeah, but I don't know, I guess that's kind of a negative and a positive. Maybe some people like that. Maybe some people like the military and they just want to see, you know, what play out. So, for sure, right? I guess that's a little bit of both, but, just another thing I noticed, right, in these first two episodes. Better action scenes this episode, I will say. I mean, the intense scene of them walking to the hospital, that was really intense. And then, of course, the scene, you know, when they're getting out on the Humvees, that was really, really cool. Probably the best action scene of the two episodes so far. And yeah, so I really liked that. I thought they were better than last week's. Last week's, we had like a couple, like, kind of hints at it. But yeah, not that much. So I thought that was a big kind of a big scale event there, where they're all riding on the Humvees, you know, high speed kind of chase. And you know, all these explosions going off, shooting. So yeah, I thought that was a really great scene there, kind of highlighted in this episode. And I feel like the action scenes kind of have to, you know, be consistent in the show, because that's what people are tuning into, right? They want to see this action, they want to see the military, you know, type of stuff that goes on. And I think they need to stick with that. And even, I would say, even maybe make them better even than this episode, right? Yeah, there was a little bit, you know, there were some good parts in this, but I think they have to do a little bit more. That's what The Brave is really good for, right now at least, is their action scenes. Like, basically the whole episode is action of them doing stuff. And of course, I understand that this is a little bit more about the family drama as well. And that's good. Like I said, I really like that. I think that's a positive. But I think they also need to mix in a little bit more action and more, you know, mission type of, they're doing this right now instead of, talking about it and stuff like that. And then the last little bit was just Clay's storyline, right? Sorry, these are all just kind of like thoughts about the rating that went into it. But yeah, Clay's storyline up in the air, right? I don't know where it's gonna go. Obviously, that is gonna change in the next few episodes as we learn more. So maybe that bumps up the rating for this episode even. But yeah, that was a little bit dock of the rating there. Just, I don't know. I wasn't a big fan of it. So I'm not a big fan of Clay right now. But I guess we're not really supposed to be either. Because he's kind of, he has these, kind of qualities that are, not too admirable. But yeah, that's kind of where I'm at with that. Favorite character for this one is Ray Perry. And yeah, he's played by Neil Brown Jr. Kind of the, I guess, the supporting actor, right, in the show, to David Boreanaz. But yeah, really, really great acting from Neil Brown Jr. He was in Straight Outta Compton, for people who've seen that. And yeah, he's doing a really, really great job. Him and David Boreanaz, like, a really good chemistry too on the screen. I feel like they're doing great, and both characters complement each other really well. Kind of the opposites to each other as well, that I've noticed. So I think that's really good to see them kind of working together, and they're kind of like the two top guys, right, on the SEAL team. So yeah, that's nice to see. And I think he did some good stuff this episode. He kind of came up with a plan with Jason for this, to get all the people back. We see him with his wife, and he's really, a caring husband, caring father. Just some really good qualities to him, right? And he has some scenes with Jason about, sort of the moral decision there of leaving them, and kind of convinces them that they need to, take them with them and help them. So yeah, really, he's kind of like the moral compass so far. He kind of, always is on the straight and narrow. He knows, what's right, what's wrong, and he's really brave, right? He's really, a really good, like, SEAL team member, I guess, a soldier, for the team. So really valuable there as well. But yeah, so that just about wraps up this video for the SEAL Team Episode 2. Thank you so much for watching as usual. Again, I'd just like to thank you guys for the recent support on my videos. Yeah, I say this, the last few videos, but the channel is really growing, almost at 5,000 total views, and I've only been at this for a couple months, so I really, really appreciate it. Honestly, really happy about this, about where this channel is going, and just the recent, success of it. So I really thank you guys so much for that. And yeah, of course, if you're new to the channel, and my summer lineup is on the channel. If you watch any of those shows, The Sinner, Suits, Salvation, Zoo, Ozark, please go check them out. Check out if you have seen them, then check out my reviews for them. My fall lineup, I'm just starting The Deuce. I'm 4 episodes in, so if you're watching that, please tune into that. The Brave, I got reviews for that as well. So yeah, for sure, subscribe to the channel as well to see more reviews. And yeah, so anyways, guys, again, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next week for the SEAL Team Season 1, Episode 3. I gotta get myself off the side of the road. I gotta get myself.